So when I was a kid, there was this game called Bop It, which was a series of commands to test your reaction skills, in which you can bop it, pull it, or twist it. And I kind of connected that to today's laptops, in which you can pop out the keyboard, pull out the kickstand, and now twist it. This is the Lenovo ThinkBook Plus Twist. Let's talk about it. So, the ThinkBook Plus Twist is a flippable 2-in-1 laptop with two screens, costing $1,650, so quite the pretty penny. Now let's discuss those screens. Like I said, it's got two displays to work with, one on the inside of the laptop, and the other on the outside, which I find weird, because won't that top screen become damaged? I mean, unlike the inner screen, there's nothing protecting it. So I'm kind of iffy on that, but we'll see what happens when the reviewers get their hands on it. For the inner display, it's got a good resolution and OLED, but only 60Hz refresh rate, which for the price, that's a bit low. At this price, I'd expect something like 120Hz, bare minimum. But I digress. Let's talk about the second screen. The outer display is an E-Link screen, meaning it's kind of like a Kindle. It has a very low power output, which is great for battery life, eye strain, note-taking, etc. It's a really simple little display that can still actually run Windows. Even still, it's not too much to write home about, though it is a neat and possibly even practical feature that could be great for students. Instead of carrying both a laptop and a tablet, you can just take this. And while we're discussing convenience, I'd like to note that this laptop is super duper thin. It's impressively well proportioned for its form factor, and I really appreciate that. And with this new screen, Lenovo also paired this laptop with a stylus that allegedly, with the display, mimics the feeling of writing with pencil and paper. I don't know how accurate those claims are, but I'm sure it'll feel somewhat like that. Now, this is where things get a little dicey for this laptop. In terms of normal laptop-y things, it's kinda lacking, namely in the connectivity section. Remember how I said this laptop is impressively thin? That comes at a cost. The device has two USB-C ports and a headphone jack, which, wow, that's it. That's all it has. Again, this laptop has a ton of spectacle with the two screens, but it doesn't have a lot of practical with the connectivity. So yeah, that's not great. Let's talk about the cameras. This laptop has a standard full HD or 1080p webcam, which is not bad for the specs list. However, yeah, there doesn't seem to be any autofocus features or tracking, which for meetings can be a little rough compared to the competition. But how about the internal specs? Well, here's the thing. It does have a solid CPU, but it's advertised as up to an Intel Core i7, meaning it could actually, at the starter price, come with something a little worse, which at this price could be a bit of a disappointment. The RAM is also advertised the same way too, up to 16GB. So that's quite strange, and I wonder what it actually starts with. And it doesn't even end there. The storage also says up to 1TB, which at the starter price, the laptop surely deserves 1TB of storage. And now, how about that battery? Well, Lenovo claims it allegedly gets up to 21 hours of use, which is fantastic. But we'll need to wait and see whether that's with isolated testing scenarios. Even still though, that E-Link screen will surely help you maintain your battery life. And lastly, the release date. Right, so this device is scheduled to be released in June 2023, meaning it's coming pretty soon. It can run Windows 11 and can do anything your typical computer can do, plus more. But the real question is it worth it? Let's get on to my verdict. So, the Lenovo ThinkBook Plus Twist, is it worth it? Well, tough to tell, but for the typical consumer, no, probably not. It's got a few extra features that you really don't need. If you're looking for just a standard laptop, you should definitely check out Lenovo's other products that are a bit more economical. But if you're a student, this might actually be good for you. Now, I'm not saying that this is the best for students watching this video. It's something you should wait for the reviewers to discuss more of once they get their hands on the device. But if you're someone like me and you want a tablet and a laptop for school, one for note-taking and the other for homework, this might actually be an okay option for both. At school, I've seen a lot of people rock the MacBook plus the iPad combo quite often. Myself included. And yeah, that can be a little more expensive or around the same price if you factor in the student discount. But for Windows, there isn't too much of an alternative. I've seen a few students rocking the Surface laptop or the Dell XPS with the Surface Go 3, and that probably works well. But for most, the Surface Pro 9 is the typical Windows option, which doesn't have as much of a laptop form factor as this one. So if you are a diehard Windows or Lenovo fan, this can certainly work for you. This laptop can be a good hybrid and can help consolidate consolidate your devices. Plus, its form factor is great because it's so thin, so even better for that consolidation. And I'm sure it'll be really good for students too. So, if you're looking for a multifunctional but also fairly expensive laptop, you might want to check out the Lenovo ThinkBook Plus Twist. My name is Cyrus. It's spelled like Cyrus, but not like C Rooster. Just take out the tur. Thank you very much for watching, and have a wonderful day. Peace.